Hello, good evening, and welcome to the show. As always, we bring you issues that disturb you and your families everywhere you stay and anywhere. And today we are dealing with defense mechanisms. We are bringing you another part. We appreciate those who criticize us. You help us improve. Those who guide us and advise us, we are so grateful. And those who appreciate us, keep appreciating and keep subscribing. Namaganda Vetlis is the YouTube channel. You can always reach us at www.buildingbridgesuganda.org. Together with Councillor Grace, I don't want to waste your time.
Hello viewers, good evening once again. My name is Grace from Building Bridges Uganda. Today we are going to have part two of defense mechanisms, and we are specifically looking at displacement and denial as defense mechanism. Displacement, what is it? It is the transfer of feelings, emotions, or anxiety to another person. How does this happen? Our brain is made up of three parts, that is the id, the superego, and the subconscious. How do they work? With the displacement, the id, that is that part of our brain that does not reason, that can beat, transfers its feelings to the superego. Because the superego is the watchman for it, what does it do? When you are going to eat food that is not yours, it say, what you are doing is not right. I'm going to give another example of displacement. You are annoyed at your place of work, and then you transfer your annoyance at home. When you come back home, you start beating the children. Another example of displacement is, you are my husband, you have another relationship. When you get misunderstandings with your girlfriend, you transfer those negative feelings to me at home by barking at me or by beating the wife. Then another defense mechanism that we are going to look at is that one of denial. Denial, what does it mean? You refuse to accept something that has happened. You refuse to accept the emotions, those painful feelings that you are going through as an individual. For example, you are a girl who is in a relationship. This man you are having is married. He spends 6 months without calling you. Because of that painful action, you are in denial. You are not accepting that this man has ended the relationship. Another example of denial is, you've been tested to be HIV positive, but then you are refusing to accept your status, and you are saying, I've been bewitched, I have conflicts at work, people are bewitching me. And when we talk about this fluid, in his summary, he's also talking about the fixation or the psychosocial stages of development. And these stages, Freud says that when you miss a certain stage at early childhood development, it manifests itself at a later stage, or what he calls fixation. So thank you very much for listening, and thank you very much for watching our shows. You can visit us on Bethlehem Namaganda, or you can visit us on our website, www.buildingbridgesuganda.org. Thank you very much for listening.
Thanks for being our ardent viewer, and as always, we are very grateful for keeping with us. Until next time, stay tuned.